Hello friends, welcome to my channel Data Making. In this video I am going to discuss about other commonly used data frame operations like drop and describe and head. Okay, let us see what is the use of these data frame functions with the example. Okay, I am going to open my IntelliJ IDE. Okay, I am going to open the program which I am going to use it for these examples. So what I'm doing in this program is, so basically it's a simple Scala object class which contains a main method. So I'm just creating a spark session object, then followed by I'm just creating a simple orders data frame which contains 5 rows, right? So with this data frame we are going to perform a series of operation with this example, this drop function, a describe function, head function, right? So so in the previous example we saw what is the use of with function, with column function. So basically if you have a data frame, if you want to create a new column into the data frame, you can use a with column. Say I'm using the reference, I'm adding a reference column to that orders data frame. Then there is another function called with column rename, where you can actually change the column. So from reference to reference number I'm changing it, right? So then I am applying the filter operation. Okay, with the I'm just fetching the rows which contains car type equal to visa, and just I'm just doing the explain to see the physical plan of the data frame which I formed finally, right? Now I'm going to apply drop function. What is the use of drop function? Is example you create a column, right? The reference number, I just want to drop that column. I don't want to use it in the further transformation. I can drop it. Okay, you can pass this, you can use this drop function and you can pass the column name so that that column will be dropped from the data frame. Okay, and then I'm going to show the physical plan of the after the drop also. And basically this describe function basically it shows the basic statistics about your different columns in your data frame. So basically it is applied on the numerical column, but I just to show you how it is working on non-numerical column also, I just passed it. So basically you can say data frame dot describe, you can pass the column name. Basically if you have a numeric column, just pass the numeric column so that it's going to show you the basic statistics like min, max, standard deviation and mean, all this can count. All this basic statistics information is going to show you. And head function, there is a function called head, it is going to show you the if you can pass the numerical values, so basically the integer value, that many number of rows is going to fetch from your data frame. If you don't pass anything, it will fetch only one row from the data frame. Okay, right? So I'll run this program and I'll show you the I'll explain you the with output how it is working. So it is I'm running on my local machine, little bit slow it is, and it will take some time to start the initial phase of this application, like creating this Spark session object and then creating a data frame. For that it takes some time, and also I'm running on local mode, so the same code can be run on the cluster using Spark Summit command. Okay, so it has run, it's running now. Okay, so let's see. So it is finally, everything is run. So initially we have this data frame, right? So we have a data frame which is 6 columns, and then we added the reference column and we tried to change the reference column to reference number, and then we just applied a filter condition where car type, we're fetching rows which contains a row car type visa, and we saw the physical plan for that the final data frame. Now we want actually apply that, we want to drop that reference number column, right? So we just use the drop function and we dropped it. Okay, so and then we see this, this is a physical plan. Okay, so then and we see it is actually not it's not included that because that you already dropped, right? So basically it's going to take from the RDD, it is going to do the filter and it will going to show you. So that's how the optimization taken place in the using the Spark data frame engine. Okay, and you see this is a basic statistics. So basically I applied the entire data frame, so it's going to show the basic statistics for all the columns. Basically we should apply on the order amount on the numeric column. So because we applied in all the data, whole data frame, so it shows count how many rows basically. It has two rows, right? Because we applied on this data frame, and so count is going to show two only. Mean, it is again two, and because 2 plus 3, oh, sorry, 1 plus 3, 4 divided by, so it gives mean as 2, and then it is going to show you the standard deviation. Basically, this is like you can say valid actually column to look out. This is the count, this is the mean, and this is standard deviation, and this is the minimum value in that particular column, every column. This is the max value. Okay, so the string count is only the valid one. Okay, other stuff are not valid one because it's not a numeric value. Okay, this order ID and user ID is fine, but it's not a useful one. Okay, basically this order amount is the one useful one. And using head command, we just see it is fetching only the one row because we are not passed any integer value. If you look at the documentation of this head, so basically head does head of one. If you don't pass anything, it is going to do the head, it is going to pass one. Okay, and there is a function called first, which internally uses head. I hope this video is useful for you. Please post your feedback on the description section of my video. And also I have many videos on Spark technology and Hadoop, and also web scraping, machine learning, other stuff. Please watch these videos and provide your feedback. Please subscribe to my channel and click on bell button to get notification whenever I add new videos. Thank you so much, friends. See you in the next video.